Hi guys, today we are going to see how you can receive WordPress emails to your inbox instead of spam. Let's say you have a WordPress website and you have a contact form like this. Now if a visitor fills up this form and tries to contact you, WordPress will send you an email. So now if we go to our inbox, you can see that we have not received the mail in our inbox. Instead, it has gone to our spam folder. Because of this, you might miss important emails from your visitors. Also, if WordPress sends emails to your visitors, that can also go to the spam folder, which looks unprofessional and can make your visitors not trust your website. Now, after watching this video, you'll be able to receive all your WordPress emails to your inbox like this. Okay, I'm Brian from Website Learners, and let's fix this WordPress email issue. We are going to do this in two parts. The first part is to create a business email. Now, in order to fix the WordPress email issue, you need a business email instead of a regular Gmail address. Now, if you already have a business email, you can skip to part 2 of this video. But if you don't have a business email, keep watching. So now we are going to create a business email in two steps. The first step is to create a new email account. Now I'm going to create my business email using my hosting provider, which is Webspacekit, as it offers free business email with my hosting plan. So to create it, let's go to webspacekit.com. Now, if your hosting provider provides business email, you need to log into your hosting service. Or if you want, you can change your hosting provider to Webspacekit by watching this video. Okay, now to create our business email, let's click login and enter these details. Then click here. So we have successfully logged into our account. Now to create our business email, just click here and it will take you to this page. Just scroll down and click email accounts. Now click create email account. Here, you need to enter the business email ID you want. And here, you can see our website name. This means the email ID we create will have our site name instead of the normal gmail.com. I'm going to enter contact. So my business email will be contact@gotocloths.com. Next, you need to enter a password for your business email. I'm going to enter a password. Now make sure you remember this password since we will be using it in the upcoming steps. Okay, and here you need to select how much data you want to allocate your hosting for this email account. I'm going to select unlimited. Once you have done this, just click create. As you can see, we have successfully created our new email account. Once you've got the new email, we can go to step 2, which is to create an email forward for this business email. Creating an email forward will forward all the emails coming to your inbox where you can read your mails. Now I want to forward the business emails to my Gmail. So to create the email forward, just click here. And it will take you to webmail. Now webmail is the platform which is going to help us create an email forward. Click forwarders. Then click add forwarder. Now here, enter any Gmail ID where you want to forward your business emails. I'm going to enter my Gmail ID and click add forwarder. And now we've successfully created our email forward. So now all the emails coming to this business email will be forwarded to the Gmail inbox. To check it, let's try sending an email to our business email from a random email. So to send the email, let's go to our random Gmail account and click compose. Here let's enter our business email. Next, let's enter the subject and message and click send. And now our email has been sent. So now if we go to our Gmail inbox, you can see that we've received the email. So let's open it. Now if you click here, you can see that It was sent to our business email and we've successfully received it in our Gmail inbox. So now we are able to receive mails to our business email. Now if you try to reply to this email, you can see here, it goes from our Gmail ID instead of our business email. So next, let's see how you can send emails from your business email, which is mailed to contact@gotocloths.com. Now to send emails from your business email, we need to connect our business email with our Gmail account. Once you connect your business email to Gmail, you can send emails from your business email using your Gmail account. So to connect your business email to Gmail, let's go back to Gmail, click Settings, then click See All Settings. Now go to Accounts and Import and click Add Another Email Address. Now here, give a from name to your business email. Now this is the name that will appear when someone receives an email from your business email. I'm going to enter GoToCloths. Next, enter your business email which you want to connect and click Next tab. Now here you need to enter these details from your hosting provider. So to get these details, let's go to Webspacekit. Now just go back, scroll down and click Configure Mail Client. And it'll take you to this page. Now these are the details which we want to enter on our Gmail account to connect our business email. So first, let's copy this and paste it here. Next, copy the username and then paste it here. Now here you need to enter the password which you have entered while creating the business email. So I'm going to enter the password of my business email. Finally, let's change the port number to 465. And click Add Account. Now it will ask you to verify your email. So let's go to our Gmail inbox. And you can see, we have received an email. Let's open it. Now copy this code. Then paste it here. And click Verify. And your business email will be connected with your Gmail account. So now if we go to our settings page, you can see that our business email is connected. So we have successfully connected our business email with our Gmail account. Once you have connected the email, you can start sending emails from your business email. So to check it, let's click Compose. And if you click here, you can see that our business email is now added. So let's try sending an email from this business email. Just select the email and let's send a test mail to a random Gmail address. Now if we click send and go to that inbox, you can see that we've received the mail. Let's open it. And if we click here, you can see that the mail was sent from contact@gotocloths.com, which is our business email. And now you can send emails using your business email. So we have successfully created our business email. Once you've created your business email, next, let's go to the second part of this video, which is to connect your business email with your WordPress website. Once you connect your business email to WordPress, you will be able to receive all the WordPress emails in your inbox. We are going to connect our business email to WordPress in just two steps. The first step is to install a plugin in WordPress. So to install the plugin, let's go to our WordPress dashboard. Now go to Plugins and click Add New. Here, search for a plugin called WP SMTP. and you will get this plugin. Now to install the plugin, let's click install and click activate. So now we have successfully installed the plugin. Till now, WordPress has been sending emails to our website, so it might go to our spam folder. Now to receive emails in our inbox, we are going to use the hosting provider to send the emails. So to use a hosting provider to send the emails, let's go to the final step, which is to connect the hosting provider with your website. So to connect the hosting provider with our site, click settings and it will take you to this page. Now here, you need to enter your business email. So I'm going to enter my business email. And here, enter the from name you want. I'm going to enter Go to Clothes. Now just scroll down here, select other SMTP. Now here we need to enter these details from our hosting provider. So to get it, let's go back to Webspacekit. Now copy this. And then paste it here. Here, select SSL and just scroll down. Now here, we need to enter the username and password of our business email. So to get the username, let's go here. Now copy the username then paste it here. Next, enter the password of the business email. I'm going to enter my password and click Save Settings. Now our hosting provider will be connected with our website. So now we have successfully connected our business email with our WordPress site, which means our email issues should now be fixed and all the WordPress email will now directly go to your inbox instead of spam. So to check that, let's go to our website. Now let's say a visitor is trying to contact you and sends you a message. Now if you go to your inbox, you can see that we have got this email. Let's open it. And you can see we have successfully received the email in our inbox. So that's it guys. This is how you can receive WordPress emails in your inbox instead of spam. Now, if you don't have a website for your business, you can build one by watching this video. If you want to migrate to Webspacekit, you can watch this video. Also, make sure you subscribe to Website Learners to get more videos like this one. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Take care. Bye-bye.